Hi, welcome back to URTV. This is your show, folks. You get what you pay for. That's right. Every non-dime you send gets you this. So remember, URTV is a place where you hear the truth, but you don't care. You know, just like this show, man, it don't matter. It don't care. Because guess what? You're just going to lay on your couch anyway. You're not going to get up. You're not going to stand up. But you're going to let them women and all those others just step on you. Yeah, just step all over you. That's right. Just let them do it. And we'll show it at URTV just for you. And these special graphics, too. So what do you think, folks? Will you stop supporting your public access because your government don't want you to support it? They want you to...
Well, all right.
I can't
say...
What?
Won't you shut it up? Shut it up?
Oh, don't know.
We've had enough of this crap.
Don't
we don't like this crap.
Democracy.
We don't want no trippy graphics.
We can't.
We don't want to hear nobody
we can't
saying
have no
nothing.
Freedom.
Listen, man, I got one thing to say.
Yeah, what's that?
It's baby time. Mic on?
Short notice show.
Is your mic on?
Is my mic on today? Have I started successfully?
All right. Good job.
That's what kind of show this
is.
Hey,
can we get some clap tracks? We're devoid of clap tracks. What's going on with the clap tracks?
We don't need clap.
I'm just saying.
I don't think anybody's done anything or said anything worth clapping for yet, really.
Okay.
Oh, that works.
All right. Well, yeah, we felt bad. We tried to do a show last week. apparently, we had the loudest band that has ever been in URTV in here. Effing Blood Guilt, all right? I just want to apologize to those boys. We're incredibly sorry. That tape machine in there is what's incredibly sorry.
We'll do it again.
We'll do it again if you guys are willing. We'd like to. we had a hell of a show, though. We had a metal episode.
Metal night.
I dressed up and everything. Metal episode.
Metal episode.
Metal. It was too bad ice, though. Too evil for TV. Blacked out all of URTV equipment.
Metal.
Was gone. Was gone. we've been busy.
That's no joke, it is. Blacked out everything.
Metal.
What is going on with the audio,
it's
man?
It's hard to look hard when that crap's going on.
JB snapping hatch.
But... speaking of JB snapping hash there, this dude convinced us this weekend to enter the 48-hour film project with him. Don't look so surprised. You were there for the damn thing, all right? Dude's in the control room.
He's just not ready to play the video yet.
but we competed. We made a movie starring this fella here.
That's right.
And some of these other people that are here, you can't see them. They're all working camera, doing their own deal. but it's called The Man with the Golden Mustache. I think it's on YouTube, is it not? Yes.
Yeah, right. You can
it's
find
on
it
YouTube.
On YouTube.
Check it out. The Man with the Golden Mustache.
It's going to be on this show, too.
In case you're like, yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, all right. He's ruined it already. That's it.
I'm sorry.
It's going to be on.
In fact, can we erase the tape? Go back and say what you were going to say. Man, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, host.
You're an ass, man. You're an ass. You know?
Don't even get to play
you're
to the desk.
You're supposed to be here backing me up. No, you don't get to play me to the desk. Can I just... Damn tree in my way. My roll-in won't start. It's the meanest face I can work up, really. Yeah, one more time. We're incredibly sorry to Blood Guilt.
For that, we're going to have a moment of silence for Blood Guilt. Of deathly, deathly science. Turn off all the lights. Hold on just a minute.
I think they ruined your secret there,
behind
too.
Behind the chair so. There. You know. Every one of them.
Yeah, this is for Blood Guilt, though.
This is for Blood Guilt. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody in the audience, for being silent.
I guess we got some stuff to catch up on. I didn't really think about all the stuff I told them about on the last episode. Like, we had our badass party at the pub. It was...
Yeah. Westville Pub.
Effing rocking. Yeah!
All URTV right. Media
even the
Fest.
Clap for that.
Media
see.
Fest Saturday night after party.
The after... Yeah, that was it. That was the official
It was good
timing.
Back in February. It was great.
Back in... you know, about a month ago when we last did our show. You know?
Yeah.
Some people try and just churn it out here, and some people like us try and make this quality programming that we're delivering to you guys at home, all right? So is our roll-in ready? Yes? The man with the golden mustache. Is it time?
Because it's not ready. All right. There we go. Let's do it. Man with the golden mustache. Play on, playa. Play on, playa. Go for it. Play the movie. Time for the movie and the roll-in. Go ahead and play it.
Agent Bean, glad you can make it. It seems we have a situation on our hands. Mr. Chuck Raynow owns a perfectly legitimate moonshining business up in the hills. We have reason to believe he's starting to print counterfeit raffle tickets for this summer's annual church raffle. And that's something my county will not tolerate. I need you to infiltrate their compound. You need to be like a copperhead in the tall grass. You get in thick. You get under their skin.
You got it, Chief.
Is that all you got to say?
Yes, sir.
I'm putting all my faith in you, Agent Beam. I don't want to see your face till you got Chuck Raynow and a carton of Marlboro Lights in my office.
Oh, Agent Beam, they told me they'd be coming down here for you. Well, I figured I'd fix you up with something I could get you out of trouble. This here is not only my personal favorite steak knife, but if they don't die from the wound, they're going to get a mean case of the Tetris from it. This here... Well, that's bear mace. It's for fighting bears. And this here, the coup de grace, well, it's a 2x4 with some rusty barbed wire wrapped around it, and it will fairly officially ruin anybody's day. Fixed you up a real nice getaway bike, and that ain't it. It's over here. You got rockets, you got bike, you got smoke screen, you got road tax, and a cloaking device. Any questions?
I haven't seen you around these parts before.
Well, I hear tell you got some mighty fine shine around here. How much for a case?
Well, that depends. What's your nom de plume?
I'm Bean. James Beam.
Well, James, can I fix you a drink?
You absolutely can. I'll have a Budweiser and bourbon. And stir it around with your finger. Mmm. Baby, you're finer than a frog hair split four ways. Hey, you got any other operations around here?
You all right there, Mr. Bean?
I tell you what, I must be a cheap date tonight. This is mighty fine, mighty fine.
Wake up.
Ah, crazy devil woman!
Hello there, Beam. Should I say, Agent Beam? Check right now. Counterfeit printer, if you know what I mean. And I've devised myself a nice little scheme. Printing all these here tickets. For that pretty little truck parked right around back.
You're never gonna get away with this.
Pretty little girl's gonna hop in the sack. We just might ride ourselves around and around and around the whole county. The whole damn town gonna see me with pretty little sissy. And guess who's gonna be man about town about then, son? It ain't gonna be you, Beam. It's gonna be me. Chuck right now, son. And when I win that there Chuck, I got big plans for sissy and me, don't I, darling? Come on over here. Get
I'm
all Chuck
right
and
now. No! No! No!
I'm sorry, Intimidator.
No! I will conquer you! Get off me! Who do you think you are?
Oh! Hey!
Tickets.
You bastard, Beam!
Is that all you got to say?
Oh, James.
Baby, you one of them girls do that thing.
Mustache. How does it feel to be the man with the golden
I tell you what, Johnny, being the man with the golden mustache was a way for me to get back to my roots. Sometimes I feel like I'm too involved in the urban life.
Does that mean you dye your hair?
Back to my roots? Yeah, I dye for the roots. And the roots were had grown out and there were weeds, but I got back down to them.
That's good.
And got to wear a mustache, which was fake.
I'm pretty sure any movie you do with old J. Doug Havenstash, you have to wear a fake mustache.
Yep.
think that's a giant requirement. Speaking of,
they happen, hey, Snatch. Hey, Snappin' Hatch.
Come on. Come on. Now, we make fun of Seth for only making a couple appearances. But actually now, this guy here has helped.
Very rarely does he make an experience.
Always run sound or something back in there.
Pop out.
He is,
have
guess,
a seat.
I guess you announced from in there, but you've never been on the stage, have you?
I've been on the stage. I did the cinema
challenge. Yeah, he did do the cinema challenge.
Hello?